الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء المرسلين وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الحمد لله all praise belongs to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Today, inshallah, during the 10th night of Ramadan, that means almost one third of Ramadan is almost passing away. As you can see, it's going so fast. After 15th, you'll see, we'll start preparing for nights of Qadr. And after nights of Qadr, of course, then we start thinking of just the end of Ramadan. So we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may Allah give us the tawfiq, that the remaining time, we try to make it the best, so that it is the best of Ramadan. We have been discussing about the month of Ramadan being the month of Qiyam, month of also praying. And so far we discuss about the Nawafil prayers. Now we discuss about beautifying our prayers. It's very important, no? So there is ayat of Quran, Subhanallah, Surah Al-A'raf, Surah number 7, ayat 31. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim, Bismillahir Rahman rahim. Ya bani Adam, khuzu zinatukum inda kulli masjid. وَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. O son of Adam, or children of Adam, right? It means this is an ayat which addresses all human beings. And this is always, I often say that, I mean, when Quran says, Ya Bani Adam, Ya Ayyun Nas, this shows the universality of this Quran. And often I always remind myself and others that, no, this means that sometimes we should share with also non-Muslims. No? If you have non-Muslims at your work, for example, it's good to give them. And there are pocket size Quran also available nowadays. Just pocket size. We can keep a few, for example, extra at home when you go like this. We can do that. Maybe one day they would read and get some kind of, you know, at least empathy or guidance, never know. So Allah says, Ya Bani Adam, O children of Adam, khuzu zinatukum inna kulli masjid. Put on your adornments, zinat, in every place of worship. Masjid is place of worship, but then we see that it also extends to also namaz, as I thought. Wakulu. وَكُلُوا وَشْرِبُوا, right? Eat and drink, right? وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا, and do not waste. إِنَّهُ لَحِبُّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ, and Allah does not like those who are wasteful. That is itself also a discussion, but our discussion will be just first part. خُذُوا زِنَتُكُمْ إِنَّ كُلِّ مَسْجِدِ, that means take adornment, try to put zinat, beautify yourself in every masjid. So Allah Matabatabai, may Allah, you know, raise his position, status. One of the greatest, you know, Mufassir of the Quran, he says, putting an adornment every place of worship means dressing up beautifully when one who wants to attend masjid, place of or time of worship, which can be identified with prayer, tawaf, and also other forms of God's remembrance. Therefore, adorning on every place of worship boils down to adorning yourself for the prayer, salah, and other similar acts. Given the unconditional sense of masjid, it would include Eid prayers, daily congregational prayers, other forms of worship, remembrance. So what he's trying to say that here, Allah is trying to say that at every time of prayers, because sometimes let's say that we are coming to masjid. So when we come to masjid, maybe we are more careful in dressing, right? Because other people are there. So how we dress, maybe, even people sometimes even are careless, but generally let's say that, no, because other people are there, maybe we are more careful. But so during COVID, we are saying our prayers at home, right? So you think, okay, I'm just saying prayers at home. I can just use my pajamas and whatever. In the morning, I wake up and do this. This was not appropriate. Because keep in mind that when we say our prayers, we are saying in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that presence of Allah is at home also and also at the masjid. So this is very important. This is something which is missed out. People who say their prayers, Fajr prayers at home, often, you know, say the same, with the same clothes they will sleep at night. That means the nightgown, night prayers, which is not appropriate. We are in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we should try to beautify. It's very important. And you'll see that, you know, there are a number of hadiths and the things you are going to share. So that is one aspect of prayers, right? Then that is about beautification. Another aspect of prayers is what we are doing, coming to the masjid. That is also one of the best beauty, that we come to the masjid, which is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We leave our all the comfort, come here, either it's winter, you know, summer, we come here and say prayers. So coming to masjid and saying prayers also is part of beauty of the prayers, right? That we come to the masjid and say prayers amongst mu'mineen, which is also a great thing, right? Another aspect of beauty is internal. that when we say our prayers, we should try to say prayers with full concentration. Now, this is the biggest challenge, but we'll discuss about it. This is the biggest challenge, that often when we say prayers, our thoughts, you know, get distracted, right? Another aspect of beauty of prayers is that we say prayers, you know, following, of course, all the rules, muqaddamatus salat, especially taharat and all those things, which is, of course, wajibat, right? Which comes to masail, but we will just briefly discuss about it. And the fifth aspect of beauty of the prayers is that when we say our prayers, we recite some of the beautiful du'as, imma or tortoise, no? Besides the wajibat, there are some beautiful du'as recited in ruku, in sajda, in kunut, right? These are some of the things we beautify our prayers by you know, reciting these extra things. It's like, for example, that somebody whom you really love, right, were to ask you, give me water, you will feel like giving him maybe milk or maybe some juice, or you will say, no, don't worry, I'm going to take a fresh fruit, I'm going to make juice for you, right? Because you have that special respect for them. We are praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? So to show that, you know, there is some wajibat. Wajibat are there, of course, for people who have a very busy life or just those who want basic. But as we get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we start enjoying our prayers, you would like to, for example, recite long surahs, you would like to recite, for example, other du'as which are there. These are all beauties of salat, right? So these are five aspects of beautifying the prayers. We'll try to, inshallah, discuss whatever we can during well, you know, this morning or thing. So let me share with you some of the hadith which Agha has included, I tell us about Alamat Watai, subhanAllah. He has included a number of hadith here, and these are quite interesting, that what he has said. We just want to share one, two hadith just now. First, he takes a hadith from the 8th Imam Ali al-Musa Rida salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. He quotes this ayat, put on your adornment on every prayer. He said, this includes combing one's hair before every prayer. So this is important, right? I remember seeing a video, we were all studying in Iran many years ago, and the revolution took place. And then in 1989, Ayatollah Khomeini died. Now, before he died, he was sick in the hospital. For a number of days, he was in the hospital. And he died, so then they produced a video about his life, now, especially the last days of his life, because he was in the hospital, and then he died, and how he was buried, and everything. So when he was in the hospital, at that time, there's a video shows that he gets ready for the prayers. You know, he gets ready for, he's just bedridden, ready for the prayer. But before getting ready for the prayer, he actually takes off his comb, and combs his beard and his hairs, and then gets ready. So amongst the getting ready for the prayers, you can imagine, and maybe he didn't even know that he's being videoed because he's in the hospital. But they could see him, that he, among his preparation, this shows that we are preparing in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So actually, Eighth Imam says one of the things to just take a, what comb and do it. Of course, nowadays because of what this mask, we cannot do that, right? For us, we have to do, for example, when I remove the mask, it's very important that I should use the comb and again make sure that it's done. But this is one of the things, right? One more hadith and we'll end this thing. There's a beautiful this thing that one day, Imam Hassan al-Islam, Hassan al-Mustafa, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, he was just going with his friends. They were just going out to Medina, walking. And before Zuhr time, now this is hot time, right, in Arabia. He said, he excused his, he's with his friends, that no, it's hot just now, it's namaz time, excuse me, I'll just leave, take your leave. He went home, got ready for the prayers. When he came to the prayers, he came with the finest clothes there. So they were his friends and people were surprised. If he had known we would do this thing. Then they asked him, why you are doing that? So, subhanAllah, I saw this story in a story in a children's book, but then I was surprised that even Allama Tawatabai has mentioned this. And the fact that he mentioned something here, he's very careful about his what to include. We will discuss about it, inshallah, in future what lecture, that how much careful he is. So he says, Imam Hassan used to wear his best clothes when he wanted to pray. O son of God's messenger, he was asked, why do you wear your best clothes? He was asked this question. He explained, indeed God is beautiful and loves beauty, right? Allahu Jameel, Uhibbul Jamal, right? There is a beautiful saying, or teachers used to say, that God is beautiful and loves beauty, right? So I beautify myself for my Lord. He says, put on your adornment on every place of masjid. Now he's quoting ayat of Quran, which he quoted, right? This is why I wear my best clothes. So you can see that even Imam Hassan used to come to the masjid in those days, you know, for example, he's such a sweating, he goes home, he gets ready himself and puts on the most beautiful clothes. So it is important that when we come to masjid, all the time for namaz, but more so in masjid because we are amongst the mu'mineen, right? Let's try to put on the best of clothes, because sometimes, you know, when you are saying namaz, you see people in front of you, the way they dress things is so distracting and disturbing. You know, what for example, some things are writing, the pants are so tight, all those things is not appropriate. You know, we are saying namaz in the presence of Allah and a mu'mineen also there. So this is also part of beauty. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that as we prepare our prayers in the Muslim of Ramadan, we try to beautify our prayers. Wa salli ala Muhammad wa alihi
tahirin. Can I have the reference again? It's 737?
731.
No. Oh, no. 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 No.